Now, while many countries are still struggling to contain the virus, the island of Taiwan has had some success, despite being right next door to China, where the outbreak began. Taiwan has so far had 376 confirmed cases and only 5 deaths. This could be thanks to a swift response from the Taiwanese government. On the very last day of 2019, authorities began assessing passengers arriving on direct flights from Wuhan, checking for symptoms of fever and pneumonia. Soon after, on the 20th of January, the government activated the Central Epidemic Command Center to directly coordinate efforts by different ministries and agencies. That organization has overseen crucial measures, including border control, fighting misinformation, and providing financial relief for businesses. Well, with us to discuss his country's approach is the Taiwanese Vice President, Dr. Chen Qianzhen. He is also an epidemiologist who is recognized for his leading role in the battle. Thank you very much indeed for joining us, Dr. Chen. Your country seems to have dealt with this virus incredibly well. What can other countries learn from your approach?
Oh, first of all, I would like to wish Prime Minister Johnson gets well soon and all the best to the people of the United Kingdom. And the situation in Taiwan is quite good. And just as mentioned that by April 7, there are 376 confirmed COVID-19 cases, with including 5 deaths. And most of them were imported cases. And it is very important for us to take very quick actions. So in the combat battles with this COVID-19, we implemented a lot of measures. And our president, Tsai Ing-wen, held a meeting of National Security Council to coordinate and integrate all the multi-ministry efforts, including the quick announcement of the travel alert, optimization of border quarantine, reinforcement of 14-day home quarantine, upgrade of healthcare system for infectious disease, and adequate supply of PPEs and other medical materials, and promotion of health education and communication. And the last but not least is accelerated development of rapid diagnostic antivirus and vaccines.
Thank you for that, Dr. Chen. You've been praised for your fast response to the virus. How much have you as a country learned from previous outbreaks?
From the previous outbreak, we consider that it is very important for us to take a very quick response. And so Taiwan's all actions basically has embedded the concept of the prudent action, rapid response, and early deployment into the epidemic prevention system. So now we consider that after the SARS outbreak, we already have a comprehensive review and made amendment to our Communicable Disease Control Act. We established a command system for communicable disease control, and we strengthened our border quarantine capacity and set up diversified communicable disease monitoring system and reinforced our monitoring of density populated institution, and implemented the nosocomial infection control policies, and formulated a response plan for emerging infectious disease, and conducted drills. And we also established reference laboratory to improve testing technology and capacity. And we also organized the infectious disease prevention medical network. And last one is the implement a mechanism for activating the Central Epidemic Command Center. And prudent action, rapid response, and early deployment are very essential for this and a very good control of this pandemic.
And you've also been helping other countries try and take on the coronavirus. Just tell us a little bit more about you, how you've been helping foreign and international countries.
Yes, on the April 4th, our President Tsai Ing-wen sent a remark that Taiwan can help, and Taiwan is helping. And so we would like to let the people know that President Tsai Ing-wen said that out of the humanitarian concern, Taiwan cannot stand by while other countries are in need of help. Taiwan is actively bolstering cooperation with all countries and is willing to provide assistance to the international community in the areas of face masks, pharmaceuticals, and technologies. And We also try to, we also are committed to donate 10 million face masks to support medical personnel in countries most severely affected by the disease, including the UK. And we are also actively helping UK government procure critical materials and resources in Taiwan to contain the pandemic and protect frontline medical staff and citizens in the UK. And the US and the Czech Republic already signed a cooperation document with Taiwan. And we also would like to collaborate with UK to improve this the containment of pandemic and also to protect all the peoples in the world.
Dr. Chen, thank you so much for your very thorough answers there. Really kind of you to come on the show. That's Dr. Chen live there in Taipei for us. Thank you very much indeed.